These are Skittles.
It looks beautiful.
And this is Bruno Xavier.
Most of this product is basically sugar and fat.
He's a food scientist at the Cornell Food Venture Center.
Oh my God!
And Bruno's going to break down how these ingredients make up one of the top chewy candies in the US, with annual sales of over $185 million.
When you break the Skittles, you will see that there is a harder shell, and on the inside is a consistency of a very thick paste, almost.
Skittles did not share specifics about its recipe, but according to Bruno, these ingredients are key to that texture.
Looking at the ingredients list and the nutritional factors, we can guess what is the concentration of each one of these ingredients in the finished product. So we're gonna combine these ingredients and we'll see what we get.
First, hydrogenated palm kernel oil. Hydrogenation is what helps this oil stay solid at room temperature.
When we scoop it up, it has the consistency of butter, almost maybe a little bit more solid than butter will be at this temperature. That's why the hydrogenated palm oil is so important. It will remain relatively solid for a longer time and give you that experience of chewing into the product for a little while. So we need fat. Now we need sugar. The corn syrup will contribute to provide it some chewiness to the base, otherwise it would be just too hard.
Modified cornstarch can work as a glue to keep ingredients together. Bruno will demonstrate how that works with a little bit of water.
You need to heat up the solution. Already forming blobs. From here, it's acting like a gel already. So now the mixture of water and cornstarch has cooled down a bit. And you can see that what it was very watery in the beginning, now it's very viscous.
Only a little bit of modified cornstarch is needed, which can help bind everything together into a paste.
Starch is very messy. Let me play with it a bit. Let's see what I get. It's getting there. Ooh, it's happening. There you are, Skittles. This is a ball of dough that the base that we just made. And this is how the Skittles look like after we remove the external coating of sugar and colorant outside them. So actually this is a little bit slimier than I thought. So it was too much corn syrup. You can see that it's not hard enough.
If you compare Bruno's dough to the inside of a Skittle, the candy is slightly more white.
And that's why the titanium dioxide is added to make that base look even more white.
Titanium dioxide is a color additive used in food, as well as in products like sunscreen or foundation.
So what we added here was probably like less than 0.1%, and the effect is very noticeable.
Titanium dioxide was banned in the EU after scientists could not rule out genotoxicity concerns, but it is still approved by the FDA for use in food with limited quantities.
But there are concerns, and maybe there is more space for research to be done.
Then there's the sugar shell.
The interesting thing is that whenever you bite into it, you're always gonna feel or hear that crack of the outside layer, right?
Skittles has 10 different color additives on the label, all listed under less than 2%.
We can show how intense these colors are. So what we're gonna do is pour water on this pan here. Hopefully we're gonna see the colors diffusing towards the center.
Color additives with names like yellow 6 or red 40 are typically derived from petroleum or coal sources. And the FDA approves batches of these ingredients before use.
If you eat a spoonful of red 40, it would probably not be a good idea.
Some sources have linked specific color additives to issues like hyperactivity or allergic type reactions.
Our concerns around artificial ingredients are related to the fact that we don't know the effects of an artificial chemical compound in our bodies until we study it.
And the shininess?
I believe the wax is also used to make the surface of the Skittles look shinier. Carnauba is a type of a palm tree, very common in Brazil. Carnauba wax can be used to polish cars and make everything look shiny. And when it's melted, it behaves just like candle wax, for example. It's liquid, and as soon as it cools down, it becomes solid again. Actually, I had never heard of Skittles until I came to the United States, so I was fascinated with the amount of candy varieties that we have here. But it's a very unique product. The flavors are very thoroughly developed, very intense. The colors are very stable, and it's a very successful product. This is my favorite flavor, the red ones. I don't even know what they call the red ones. I call them red.